Later in the evening, David and two other singers went to Chapman's flat to record a party CD based on The Tempest. After a fun-filled evening, the group went into town for coffee and cake. Chapman and David were going to meet up the next week for dinner. We were to plan to also make an appointment for the gym as well, so we were establishing contact and becoming friends of a sort. Arawa spent the Friday before her death studying with friends for an exam they were setting the following Monday. The group arranged to go out for lunch together after the exam. One of them was Greer Taylor, who knew the Bain family fairly well and thought of David as a tall, gangly geek who was friendly enough. She had a bit to do with David as they both went to the same weekend workshops for their university music paper. I thought David was quirky and funny. He was a different person once he was on stage at the music workshops. He went from being this geeky guy to someone who commanded the whole stage, very confident, as if there was no one on stage but him. It was quite surprising. He went from one extreme to the other. A few weeks before the murders, her boyfriend, who had been one of David's classmates, warned her that David had told him about his rape fantasy during their last year at school. Knowing that about David disgusted me and made my skin crawl. After that, she said, I didn't want David anywhere near me. After their study session, Arawa and her friends walked towards the university. David came to pick Arawa up. He was not himself, not friendly. He kind of hustled Arawa away. Where Arawa and David went is unclear, but at about 5:30 p.m. on Friday evening, Arawa met her friend Tim Smith, an 18-year-old law student, and they decided to have a meal together at the student union. They had met through theatre sports the previous year and became good friends.